Good morning, students. In today's class, regarding to one word substitutes, already I have completed four parts, and today's class is part number 5. In this class, I am going to explain 10 one-word substitutions or one-word substitutes. Please listen carefully. The first one is radio jockey. What is the meaning of radio jockey? Please listen carefully. Concentrate on that one word substitutes, radio jockey. This is the first one in this class. The meaning is someone who presents or hosts opposite of guest a radio show. He is called radio jockey. Radio jockey, a radio presenter. Radio jockey means a radio presenter. And it is abbreviated only RJ. A person who hosts a talk show on radio, he is called radio jockey. Radio jockey, one who hosts the show, reads the, he has also reads the script or plays the music and audio advertisements and design subjects for a discussion and interacts with callers, phone callers. He is the radio jockey. He is able to engage two audience, AUDIENC, with his voice or her voice. Radio jockey may be a woman or a man. Voice modulation. Radio jockey has the good qualities of voice modulation and accurate pronunciation also, and command over the language and vocabulary, flair and fluency in language. These qualities must have a radio jockey. A good sense of humor, a control over voice pitch. Remember, radio jockey, a person whose job, what is his duty? He is to introduce different sections of programs or play recorded popular music on the radio. For example, one of the uses I will. He is a television, not only radio or television also. He is a television anchor. And television anchor, comma, he is a radio jockey. Radio J-O-C-K-E-Y, radio jockey. And former journalist also, former journalist also, J-O-U-R-N, journalist also. He is a television anchor, radio jockey, and former journalist also. This is the one of the usage, my dear students. And here one of the usage, a radio jockey needs to have a brilliant communication skills. It is a good quality, one of the quality of characteristic of the radio jockey, my dear students. A radio jockey needs to have brilliant communication skills. Not only a communication skill, he has a flair and fluency in language, good sense of humor, control over voice pitch, and command over the language and vocabulary. Language and vocabulary. These qualities, these characteristics must have the radio jockey. And then the next one word substitute in this class is second one word substitute is here. You should all of you watch this screen. And second one is choreographer. Choreographer. Choreographer means someone who choreographs dances, tuning certain sequences of steps and movements along music. This is the definition of choreographer, explanation of. Tuning means tuning, to make someone able to understand or recognize something. That is the attuning. For example, you will be attuned to the sound of the composed tune up. Put into tune in the piano. A tune means melody, M-E-L-O-D-Y, melody. She left the theater humming a cheerful tune, T-U-N-E, tune, a tune. That means a person who composes. Choreographer means a person who composes the sequence of steps, S-E-Q-U-E-N-C, sequence of steps, sequence of steps and moves for a performance of dance, is the choreographer. He is a dance master, choreographer. A person who creates dance, compositions and plans and arranges dance movements and patterns for dances and especially for ballet, B-A-L-L-E-T, ballet means one type of the dance, T is a silent, ballet. I have explained this word in silent letters, silent consonants. I made 5 videos on silent consonant, nearly 50 words, silent consonant or silent letters videos. So all of you requested to watch those videos, my dear students. For example, choreographer is a dance master. For example, he is the well-known. He is the well-known choreographer. He is the well-known choreographer, dancer and composer, dancer and composer. This is one of the uses. Choreography means what does it mean? Choreography, the art of composing dances and arranging the movements, steps and patterns of dances. That is the choreography. One who studies choreography, one who practices choreography is called a choreographer. And then one of the usages here. Can you find me a wedding choreographer here? Can you find me a wedding choreographer? Can you find me a wedding choreographer? This is the one of the usage, my dear students. Third one, after completion of 2 1 word substitutes, third one word substitutes in this class is curator. This is the third one. Curator means someone who is the custodian or the keeper of a museum. He is the supervisor for the museum. He is a guardian, custodian to protect the museum. He is called a curator. Curator. A keeper or custodian of a museum and other collection. A person in charge of a museum. In charge, in charge of the museum. A person in charge of a department of a museum, other places where objects of art, science are from, the past are collected, or a person who organizes, he is also organizes. A person who organizes or showing of art, other objects, he is called a curator, which is a common noun, curator. Curator means one in charge of a museum, not only museum, but also zoo also, curator. Curator means in charge of museum, zoo, other place of exhibit. Other place of exhibit, exhibition places, is a responsibility person. A guardian or a manager, a superintendent, a curator means. Someone whose job, what is the job? To look after, it is a phrasal verb. Take care of, to look after. The objects in a museums, not only museums, libraries also, art galleries, G-A-L-L-E-R-I-S, art galleries. It is the duty of the curator, whose job is to look after the objects in a museums, libraries and art galleries. He is a curator. The duties of the curator is a look after, a keeper, observer and protector, custodian, manager or guardian of the libraries, galleries, zoo or museum. He is called a curator. For example, one of the usage I will give you my students. He was appointed an assistant curator in the department of printed books. He was appointed an assistant curator. That means he is a guardian of the department of the books. He is a manager of department of the books. He is a superintendent of department of the books. The curator guided us around the museum. He guided us. The visitors follow the curator. He guided the visitors who are visiting the museum or zoo also. That is the meaning of the curator explanation. And here one usage. I like being a curator as I get to meet artists from different parts of the world. I will become a curator in my future. I wanted to become a curator. I like being a curator. I am interested in the duty of the curator. Why? Because as I get to meet artists from different parts of the world. That is the one of the usage, my dear friend. And then next, one word substitutes, we have completed 3 one-word substitutes and the fourth one is in this session, in this class, misanthrope. The phonetic transcription is misanthrope means, or misanthrope means, misanthrope. Here the definition, a person who doesn't like mankind. He hates humankind. He doesn't like humanity. He avoids and divides. Divides means entirely lacking or free from. To lack be without something that is necessary or casual. That is the divides. He far away from the humankind. In human society. He is a misanthrope, a person who hates opposite of love. He does not love the humankind. He does not like the humankind. He dislikes the humankind. He hates the humankind, mankind. mankind hater. He is a hater. He is a mankind hater. Misanthrope. A proper noun, misanthrope. Sorry, proper noun, common noun. And misanthrope is one who hates humanity. That type of person is called misanthrope. Opposite of misanthropo is one who loves mankind is a philanthropist. Already I have explained this one, philanthropist. This is the opposite. He loves humankind. He devotes his service to the humanity. This is the antonym of misanthrope. Misanthrope opposite, one word, humanitarian. 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 He likes, he devotes his service for the human society. He always wants the welfare of the humanity. These two words opposites of the misanthrope. He hates humankind. And then one of the usage, Grinch wasn't the mean-spirited. Mean-spirited. Mean-spirited means he's a selfish person. Grinch is one of the proper noun. That particular person, mean-spirited. It is an adjective. Adjective means it gives something, explanation about the, additional information about the noun, misanthrope. Really is a misanthrope. He hates humankind. He doesn't like humanity. But mean-spirited. That means malicious kind. Feeling or showing a desire to cause harm. That means to cause harm to others. That type of person is called that type of malicious quality. It is a bad quality. It is a unpleasant quality. To cause harm or pain is a cruel quality, unkind, nasty, malignant quality. Grinch wasn't the mean spirited. Wasn't, not. He is not a mean spirited misanthrope. Most of us took him to be. That type of qualities he doesn't have, wasn't, it is a negative sentence. Grinch wasn't, was not the mean spirited misanthrope most of us took him to be. Wasn't means that type of bad qualities, that type of unkind or cruel or nasty, malignant quality, that type of cause harm to pain, to the humanity. He is a selfish person. He is a selfish person. That type of person, he is not a selfish person. He is a good person. He was not the mean-spirited. That is the usage, my dear student. And next word. The next word is the fifth word. What is the fifth one-word substitute? Numismatist. The fifth one word substitute is numismatist. Numismatist means, what is the definition? A person who collects coins as a hobby. It is a habitual action, hobby. A person who collects coins, that person is called numismatist. Numismatist. Numismatist, the study of collection of coins, tokens, and paper money, and sometimes relate to objects also. Objects also. Someone who studies or collects coins, paper money, or medals, medals also. He is an expert on coinage, 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 coins collector. He was an expert in, for example, he was an expert in economic and finance, and he was known as a numismatist. Not only this, economic and finance. And he was known as numismatist, that means coin collector, collecting of the coin, he is called numismatist. paper notes and coins will be valued only. Numismatist, paper notes and coins will be valued by numismatist. Paper notes and coins will be valued by numismatist. He was an expert in economic affairs and finance, and he was known as numismatist. He studies or collects coins, paper money or medals. He is called numismatist. As a numismatist, one of the usages he has given, I have a huge collection of currencies from almost all the countries around the world. He is collecting currencies from almost all the countries around the world as a numismatist. I have a huge collection. Huge means large or big. It is an adjective, large or big collection. That is the usage, my dear students. And then we go to the next one word substitutes. The sixth one is, what is the sixth one? This is the sixth one. The sixth one, one word substitute is chauffeur. Chauffeur means, what is the meaning? Someone employed, appointed as an employee to drive a hired car, that is more important. Not own car, hired car. A private vehicle, V-E-H-I-C-L-E, vehicle, H is a silent, vehicle. The correct pronunciation is vehicle, not vehicles. Some students mispronounced this word vehicles. It is a wrong pronunciation. H is a silent vehicle. A person employed to drive a private or hired vehicle. Hired vehicle means a private, not only car, a cab, private vehicles. Chauffeur means, it is difficult spelling. C-H-A-U-F-F-E-U-R. Chauffeur. Chauffeur means a person employed to drive a private automobile. A-U-T-O-M-O-B-A-L-E. Automobile. A private vehicles. Automobile means. That means whose job? What is the job? What is the duty? To drive a car. For a rich or important person, that person is driving a car for rich and important person, rich and important person, is a automobilist. Chauffeur means driver, a private driver, appointed as a hired car, private car. Not only car, vehicles. Motorist. Chauffeur means motorist or driver. A man paid to drive a privately owned car. It is the meaning of the definition of the chauffeur. The chauffeur will come by 4 p.m. to the venue. Venue means place, particular place. The chauffeur will come by 4 p.m. to the venue. A person employed to drive a private or hired vehicles. That is the usage of my tool. The chauffeur will come by 4 p.m. to the venue. That is the usage. And then we go to the next word. That is the seventh one. The seventh one is pedestrian. pedestrian. This is the phonetic stance. Pedestrian means someone who walks not by preposition, on foot. On is a right preposition. Someone who walks on foot. A person walking rather than traveling in a vehicle or vehicle, V-E-C-H-I-C-L, vehicle, he is walking on the road. Along the road, a pedestrian is a person traveling on foot, not by foot, on foot. Whether walking or running, it may be, he is a pedestrian. Pedestrian is a right pronunciation. And then a person who is walking especially in an area where vehicles go. And it is also a person going on foot. Pedestrian is a foot traveler, traveling on foot, walking on foot, running on foot, is called a pedestrian. That means it is also used an adjective. In some occasions, not only a noun, adjective also. What is the meaning of an adjective? Adjective, pedestrian means not interesting or dull or boring. Boring, not interesting, I-N-T-E-R-S, not interesting. That is another meaning, as it has been as an adjective. The meaning of an adjective pedestrian is not interesting or dull or boring. For example, that means showing very little interest. That is the meaning of pedestrian, it has been used as adjective. For example, His speech is long and pedestrian. Pedestrian, long and pedestrian. His speech is S-P-E-C-H. His speech is long and pedestrian. Here, pedestrian means not interesting or dull or boring, showing very little interesting. That is the meaning of it. Is used long an adjective. Pedestrian is also an adjective, not a noun. This is one of the usages, my dear students. For example, a bicyclist and pedestrians use the path. P-A-T-H, path, that means the way. Bicyclist. Who is riding a bicycle? Bicyclist and pedestrians, bicyclists and pedestrians use the path, P-A-T-H, the path. Path means the way. That is the meaning of the pedestrian. It has two meanings. One is as a noun and is as a adjective. For example, this side of the road is for pedestrians. Foot travelers are walkers. W-A-L-K-E-R, walkers. Who is walking on foot are walkers. That is the usage, my dear students. And we go to the next word. One word substitute is... That is the eighth one, introvert. What is the meaning of introvert? Someone who is reserved and shy. Reserved is an adjective, shy is an adjective. That type of qualities who has, he is called an introvert. He is a shy person, a reticent person. Someone who is shy, quiet, Q-U-I-T, quiet person. And he prefers to spend alone. Introvert prefers to spend time alone, lonely, rather than often being with other people. He did not interested to discuss, to meet other people. What is the opposite of introvert? Introvert antonym is extrovert. extrovert, extrovert. That means he mingled with other people. He sociable is type of quality. An introvert is quite shy person who finds it difficult to talk to people. He feels difficult to talk other people. To talk other people is called introvert. The extrovert is very feels very easy to talk to mingled with other people. Introverts feel more, for example, extrovert feel more comfortable and focusing on their manner. The introvert does not like to talk with other people. This is the meaning of the introvert, my dear students. The introverts are always comfortable focusing on their inner thoughts. Introverts. Always focusing inner thoughts. And ideas rather than what is happening externally. They don't care. They don't concentrate on what is happening externally. They enjoy speaking time with just one or two people rather than large group of people. Large group of people. They did not interested to meet large group of people. They enjoy spending time with just one or two persons, introverts. Opposite is extrovert. And the usage is, I like being an introvert and I am happy with a small social circle. Small social circle, not a large or big. I like being an introvert. I am happy with a small social circle. But actually, introvert is not a good quality. We mingle with society that we should not spend time alone or lonely. It is not good to feel shy or quiet or prefers to spend time alone. For example, he is one usage I will give you. He is an introvert. And reserved person. R-E-S-E-R-V-E-D. Reserved person. He is an introvert and reserved person. Who spoke little. He is an introvert and reserved person who spoke little. That is one of the usage, my dear students. And we go to the next word. That is the ninth word. One word substitutes. That one is... Okay, my dear students. This is the ninth one. A-E-O-N. What is the pronunciation? The pronunciation is Ian. Ian. The pronunciation is Ian. Ian means indefinite period, not definite period. A long period. For eternity. E-T-E-R-N-I-T-Y. Eternity. A long period. Forever. A long period. Eon means. An indefinite and very long period of time. That is the meaning of eon. Eon means an extremely long period of time. Thousands of years. Extremely long period. Thousands of years. Eon means a period of 1,000 million years. A very long period. An extremely long period of time. An indefinite, not definite. Very long period of time. That is the meaning of the... I will give you one usage. Eons ago, A is a silent. Eons ago, a long period of time ago, indefinite, there were deserts, D-E-S-E, deserts. where there is no fertile land. Fertile land, FYRTL, fertile land. Years ago there were deserts. Now there is a fertile land. That is one of the usage, my students. Eon means a long period. Those days become boring. And eon and too long to pass. Eon and too long to pass. Eon means a period of time in extremely indefinite time. Very long period of time. That is the meaning of that sentence. Last word. That is the 10th one. This is the last one word substitute in this class. A-E-S-T-H-E-T-I-C-S. What is the pronunciation? Aesthetics. 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 This is the phonetic translation. Aesthetics. Aesthetics means, what is the definition of the aesthetic means? It's one of the study subject. Appreciation of beauty by set of principles. The study of beauty. Aesthetics means the study of beauty. It is the branch of philosophy which deals with the questions of beauty and artistic taste. Artistic taste. It is a branch of philosophy. Aesthetic is one of this paper on subject. What is the meaning of aesthetic? It means the pleasant, positive, artificial appearance of a person or a thing. It is a set of principles concerned with the nature and appreciation of beauty. Appreciation of, that is the meaning of aesthetics. Relating to the enjoyment or study of beauty. Aesthetic means relating to the enjoying or study of beauty. B-E-A-U-T-Y, beauty. Ornamental. Aesthetic means ornamental. It is also used an adjective. Adjective, not a subject also, an adjective. Aesthetic means ornamental or artistic or pleasing or pretty, beautiful, pretty. Ornamental, aesthetic means ornamental, ornamental, aesthetic means. It is an artistic. When you used an adjective, I will give you one of the usage, my dear student. The new building has aesthetic value. A-E-S-T-H-E-T-I-S. Aesthetic value. Aesthetic, it has been used as an adjective. Aesthetic means here ornamental, artistic, pleasing, pretty or beautiful. The new building has aesthetic value means it is a beautiful building. It is a ornamental building, artistic building, pleasing building to talk about beauty. That is the has been used as an adjective. But this is one of the branch of the philosophy which deals with the questions of beauty and artistic taste by set of principles. That is called aesthetic, my dear students. And then one more usage. I found this website quite appealing. Especially because of its aesthetics. That is the one of the uses. And then I have completed 10 one-word substitutes. Already, how many parts I have completed? 4. This is the fifth part. That means I have completed in each part 10 one-word substitutes. 50 one-word substitutes I have completed, my dear students. I will suggest you should watch the previous videos, 1, 2, 3, 4 parts which relating to the one word substitutes. All of you, goodbye and thank you once again, my dear.